Do I dare? Let's put it on her hand. 5 damage. The moment you slip your fingers into the glove, the gauntlet bites down on your arm. It feels like millions of razors slide up and down your arm, flaying the skin, then the muscle, then the bone. It's so bad that you pass out from the pain. When you wake, the gauntlet lies on the ground and your hand is regrown. It seems your regenerative abilities are stronger than the gauntlet's hunger. Even so, you feel some of the gauntlet's power in your newly regrown hand. Sweet. I permanently gain 1 speed pool. Oddly, nothing happens when you put the gauntlet on this time. For whatever reason, it does not consume your newly grown hand. Sweet! So now I guess we sell the thing, because we can't use it again. Interesting. Very interesting. That's cool. That's a way to gain 1 speed pool. I mean, the 5 hit points you can gain back easily.
All right.
Once we get back to Member Vera's courtyard, we're going to sleep anyway, so we'll regain that. What's this? Oh, it dried up? Well, that's inconvenient. Looks like we're taking the long way back, whatever that is. Oh, boy. The portal to a Chirurgeon's slump is gone. All that remains is a hideous scar. Shall we listen to the tongue cluster again? I'm guessing we can go through here now. Maybe. As you approach, the voices of the bloom begin to click and buzz in your ears, making your fingers twitch and setting your teeth on edge. You catch yourself reaching instinctively for the magmatic annulet, as if it's something you've done many times before. Touch the magmatic annulet. You grasp the crystalline artifact. At once the voices of the bloom grow louder, and louder still. They fill your consciousness, drowning out your thoughts, hissing and whispering, and chittering and buzzing. They're coming from every direction, from above and below, from nearby and far away. Swaying on your feet, you nearly topple to the floor. Slowly the bloom voices resolve themselves into their constituent parts, but now they carry sense impressions with them. Hunger, curiosity, desire. Each burst of bloom voices evokes a new impression in your mind. For a moment, you let go of the annulet, and the sense impressions are gone. The voices are nothing but meaningless babble. Then you touch the annulet again, and the sense impressions return. You realize that the magmatic annulet is a translator of sorts, though the limits and scope of its power are uncertain. Listen to the nearest voices. You hear the cluster of bloom voices whispering softly to you, exuding a sense of expectation and familiarity. These tongues know your scent, or perhaps that of your sire, and they are eager to touch your mind, but their voices are not the only ones here. A score of other voices gibber and shout from the dark corners of the room, ordinary human voices that once belonged to the merchants, guards, and bloom guides who were devoured here. Fragments of their minds cling to life in their half-digested corpses, and they cry out in confusion, rage, or pain. I wonder why the Bloom Damar wanted all these people. It's so disgusting. Listen to the distant voices. You focus on the Bloom voices that are coming from outside the trade post. What seemed at first like an indistinct babble is actually many different voices. Thousands of voices, each arising from somewhere else in the Bloom. Some of the voices belong to individual maws, evoking impressions of hunger and need. Others resonate from deeper places within the bloom. When you concentrate on those voices, you experience flashes of intense emotion or catch fleeting glimpses of men and women being beaten or killed. merely being beaten or killed. Every voice is unique. Chittering, groaning, barking, whispering, rattling, hissing. Yet all of them are the bloom. The bloom tongues whisper softly to you, tickling the edges of your consciousness, like tiny wriggling fingers trying to reach inside your mind. Every few moments, the whispering tongues are drowned out by the voices of the men and women who were devoured in this chamber. They shriek in confusion and anguish, unaware that they are already dead. Try to communicate with a cluster of bloom tongues. Relaxing your mind, you allow the whispering of the bloom tongues to penetrate your thoughts. Memories rise into your consciousness, trivial moments you thought you had forgotten. Just as you recognize them, they are swept away. The bloom tongues are sifting through your memories, looking for something. The changing god? The voices dig deeper into your unconsciousness. Unconscious. What seemed harmless at first becomes irritating. A dull ache blossoms in the back of your head, spreading across your skull and down your spine. The pain comes in waves, as if the bloom is trying to wrench a memory out of your brain. If we do the tidal surge, the sorrow might come. What if we allow the bloom to feed on a memory? Do I lose intelligence? I hope not. 3 damage to health. Dimly, you are aware of the bloom's presence in your mind, pulling at a memory hidden deep in your unconsciousness, like a stubborn tooth that refuses to be torn out. With a final gout of searing agony, the memory bursts into your conscious mind. You stand under a blazing purple sun that was never of the ninth world you know. Your body sits heavy on you, unfamiliar muscles rippling as you move. And move you must. As your boots lose their propulsive power, you must scramble at the sheer rock face for the extra boost, pulling yourself up with your battered hands, trying to reach the eye socket of the mountain-sized statue. You laugh madly, and you can feel your consciousness straining to leave this shell. Am I reliving a memory of the changing god? I guess so. You gain the safety of the carven eye. You look below to see your pursuers swarming up the cliff. You are defiling their holy ground, and they mean to make you pay in blood. Their lamprey mouths, like their many arms, and the needle-capped suckers on their hands all suggest that they are more than capable of taking it. Except as they come, you hold your hand out above them and curl it into a fist. The air coalesces into an acid shower that rains down among them. Their screams are like an opera. Wow. The memory ends, slurped from your mind like a sugary nectar. You remember witnessing it, yet the memory itself, the collection of sensory impressions that was actually experienced by the changing god, is gone, devoured by the bloom. The bloom tongues sag drunkenly against each other, as if the feast has made them languid and confused. Try to take control of the bloom tongues. 90%. You reach across the barrier that separates your consciousness from that of the tongues, a barrier now made permeable by the annulet. Tentatively, you begin to direct the motions of the tongues. It's a strange sensation, like having another set of limbs, but they respond to your impulses. Belatedly, the tongues try to resist, but with a bit of concentration, you quiet them like errant thoughts. These tongues, you realize, are a tiny locus of the bloom's consciousness. Their roots extend through the trade post, and now so do your thoughts and commands. Cool. Can I do all these things? Release the human minds that are trapped in the trade post. Gold tide. Moderate amount. A few moments of concentration reveal that the snaking roots of the bloom tongues are still connected to the corpses. Hair-like fibers grow through the putrefying flesh, linking to their half-dead brains, keeping their minds alive. And I realize by choosing this, we probably can't steal their thoughts, but I don't think I should be doing that anyway, really. Yeah, it's gone. You force the bloom tongues to withdraw their fibers from each of their bodies. One by one, the gibbering voices cease, and the tortured minds fade and die. Move the trade post back to its original location. You close your eyes and relax your mind, probing the limits of your new senses. The roots of the bloom tongues run throughout the trade post, but they also extend some distance into the surrounding flesh. A few of them trail upward, tracing a small path toward an open cavity in the outer reaches of the bloom. Whoa. Steeling yourself, you take hold of all the tendrils at once, urging them back along the path, clawing their way toward the surface and dragging the trade post after them. The ground buckles and churns beneath your feet, and the whole chamber begins to move. At last you open your eyes and the shaking subsides. The blocked archway is opening. You hear astonished voices outside. Oh cool, these open. Now we can explore some more. Their energy spent, the bloom tongues recede into the ground. Ah! The bloom tongues are receded into the ground. You can no longer communicate with them. Well, damn it. So we can't open this, still. So hopefully through here we can find another way back. I mean, if we can't, then that would be stupid. So now maybe we can buy stuff at the trade post. Oh, it's like the entry. An entryway to the vast interior, huh?
On it.
On it. Hello there. As you emerge from the trade post, you hear sharp intakes of breath. The two merchants you met earlier are staring at you in amazement. That great jaw and the teeth, they're gone. The portly human beams at you. Was this your doing? If it was, you have our deepest thanks. But we are no better off, the Vargellin points out. Our wagon is still supper for Bloom Thing. Quite right, the human frowns. But it's still damned impressive. I thought the bloom only answered to the Memovira. Where is she when we need her help, eh? The bloom is eating our wagon. I don't suppose you could lend us a hand? He says the same exact thing. Where's that dude? Where's the bloom guide? Yeah, it looks like that guy is gone. He's standing right there. Oh, there he is, Grisla. Grisla squints at you. You spoke to her, didn't you? To the bloom, I mean. And she listened. He thinks, no wonder the Memovira wants to get rid of her. Huh. The Memovira wants to get rid of me, huh? Is that unusual? I know it is. I'd say so. Nobody but the Memovira can command the bloom like you did. And some folks say even she can't do it anymore. Of course I ain't one to believe those rumors. He thinks, I don't need to believe the rumors. I know the fact that she can't. Guess I'd be careful about using that kind of power if I was you. The folks in charge might mistake you for a threat. Happens a lot around here, and I'd hate to see it happen to you. It's okay, we'll just kill them. He shrugs, and a lopsided grin returns. Now, what can I do for you? I know all about the bloom and her maws. We've asked these already. And we've asked these already, so... Farewell. You ever need advice about the bloom, come and find me again. Halonine. I know, for some reason, it's like we can interact with it, but it doesn't even grunt or growl or do anything. Well, that's part of that. How did you open that maw? I've never seen anything like that. Never. I can't believe the trade post is open again. I thought that way was closed forever. And now we just need people in it again. They tell me you open the trade post, but I keep saying that the bloom can make you see things. I guess we can interact with this thing. It looks as if the bloom has begun to devour this wagon. Its wheels have been sucked down into the flesh of the platform. Even as you watch, it slowly recedes a little further into the ground. The merchant's guards heave and push at it to no avail. Might. Might makes right. Help the guards pull it free. I got 60%. Me. 65 for Tiber. Same. And you know Calisthenes is going to be horrible. Let's have Eretus help. He gets into things like this. Success! Critical success, nice. Without a word, you throw your shoulder into the back of the wagon and begin to heave in time with the guards. Surprised at your sudden generosity, they slacken for a moment, and then, as if trying to prove themselves, redouble their efforts. You can feel a great, almost ultrasonic rumble of displeasure as the bloom's flesh begins to tear. Fibers pop, one at a time, and suddenly the wagon is free, and you stagger after it. In the fissure that was devouring the wagon, you see an object. Some bit of Numenera, but the bloom flesh is already closing over it. Of course I'm going to try to grab it. Now, we gave him a bonus, Tiber. He can get to 100. Cool. I got another cipher. You drop quickly to your knees and plunge your arm into the rat. Your fingers close over the device and you pull it out of the wound before the bloom flesh knits itself back together. Orb of Perception. Permanently increase intellect by 1 and gain Orb of Perception. Plus 2 training level in perception skill. Okay, active until next sleep. Well, I'm guessing the plus 2 training level is active until next skill because this is permanent. Plus 2 training level. I'll probably just take it now. Use it now. Take it. A perfectly spherical orb, half a fist in diameter. It looks and feels to be made of dark green, transparent glass, though you cannot see through it. It catches all manner of light in its center, and peering into it gives one the sense of abstract wisdom. Touching the orb to your temple will alter your perception of reality forever. Actually, I'm going to rest soon, so I'm going to wait. I'm going to wake up and take that, use that. It would take immense power to break or blemish this orb. You are certain this orb has been utilized many, many times before you possessed it. It appears to be on its final charge now. Okay. You have our thanks. You have our thanks, stranger, says the eldest of the guards. If we'd lost a wagon, we'd have lost our pay. You're a damn sight more helpful than most around here. Why don't you go talk to our employers over there? Maybe they'll have something for you. Sweet. More goodies. Thanks for your help getting that wagon out. I guess. Don't think you worked as hard as I did. Oh, God. Sure, I'm glad you were here to help get the wagon out. Yeah, talk to your friend. He's being a jerk. Couldn't have freed that wagon without you, friend.
Of course.
Huh. Funny how it looks like we could interact with that, but not really. Yep, I'm still here. Something you need. Am I stuck? Okay. Ha! I never thought we'd free that wagon. The human merchant grins like a madman and does a little jig, his massive head lolling back and forth like a pendulum. He thinks first good thing that happened to us in this godforsaken monster. Here, he tosses you a purse of shins. 240 shins, we're over 5,000 now. That's the same as I pay the Memovira for our passage into the bloom, and you're a lot more deserving than she is. You hear that, you great greedy wench? He shouts in the direction of the Memovira's courtyard and spits derisively. Huh. We're packing up for ascension, friend. We'll see you in the trade post when we return. Now, can I just go into the trade post? Because I want to buy some stuff. I have so much friggin' money. Now I want to trade. It'll be set up now. We're packing up for the ascension, they said. Let me check in the ascension.
Yes.
Maybe they're gonna sell things from there. Well, I'm not seeing them. Alright. I don't see anybody, so...
Alright.
And still not here. I guess something has to transpire before they return here. Or maybe they never do, I don't know. How do I leave the... I have to move the portraits aside. This little beastie is cute. Yeah, they're still hanging out here.
Naturally.
Well, I forgot to look up. There's a codex entry for these things. Those gem things. Crystal vores are insectoid beings of unknown origin. They generate a chemical process that dissolves crystal, using it to hollow out crystalline chunks to serve as shells. They use their sharp mandibles, talons, and claws to make short work of those who intrude on their nests. They frequently withdraw within their shells, falling into a dormant state until they are disturbed. Yeah, we saw that happen. Locations. We don't have a section for trading post. Huh. Surprising. Alright. Now, I just want to see...
Here comes the boredom slayer!
If she has anything. So I can't think of anyone else that sells things around here. So she has two spray fleshes. Oh, these are moths. Liquid Death. I sold that. Talisman of the Gentle Hierophant. Huh. Max effort plus one on non-combat tasks. On plus one on non-combat, minus one on attacks. I'll skip that. Well, that's what I just looked at, right? So what's this? Well, Liquid Death. Plus 30% evasion. Plus one training level and quick fingers. Negative 2 armor, though. Negative training and endurance. Oh, I'll get this. Heals 20 points of health and removes all negative fetals from all allies in range. So that means 20 points of health on all allies as well, or just the negative fetals? This brass hoop surface has incredibly intricate engravings. If twisted, the hoop falls apart and all emotion is swept from the area. Still mirrors had a proud history. Once they were used to maintain order, but the few that remain today are carefully guarded and used for darker purposes.
My ciphers are making me ill.
I know. That's a cipher as well. How many should she... Hold on. I want to make sure I don't... Oh yeah, that's a lot. Okay. That just cancels out one negative fetal. Okay, we're gonna sell the Ring of Elamor. And we're gonna sell her Burning Mouse thing. And then we're gonna mess with stuff again. Not Burning Mouse. Panoramic Capture Ball. It's an interesting thing, but I can unravel the Fog of War myself. So we've gained that money back. Actually, I have almost as much money as I just did. Many points of health. Get out the Count Stige. And what's this? Oh, I'm gonna use this after I sleep. Shell armor. Hmm. What shall I move? Give this to Aratus. Tiber has this whole time. That's pretty sweet. I should be using that next time. Quantum detonation. Oh yeah. So now I can buy this one last fettle. Not fettle. It's gonna give me a fettle. Panacea. Heals 30 points of health on all allies in range of target point. A thin cooling gel mortars the stacked ceramic discs that make up this device. Turning the topmost disc triggers a glowing field that cures even the most grievous injuries.
I'm carrying too many ciphers.
You're gonna be okay. These are the ones I just sold. Clockwork strut. Yeah, I'm gonna leave it. Okay, now this, I could sell the slug spitter. And the gauntlet. Can't use it again, right? And I'm pretty sure I'm gonna keep everything else. Even though I'm not using some of it, I can always sell it somewhere else. So, as far as... I'm gonna get rid of a cipher in a few minutes, because I'm gonna use it. No one else has any spaces left, so... If anyone's gonna have one cipher, I guess it might as well be me.
To action!
Okay. Let's get some rest. With Kian, we can rest for free. Bloop.
Ah, that's more like it.
Okay, now use this. Permanently increase intellect by one and plus two training level and perception skill, which I believe the intellect is permanent and the plus two is until next sleep. Then we never know when we're going to need more perception, so might as well just use it now and get rid of Fettle. So we just look. I am 22 intellect.
That's the stuff.
23, nice. Sweet. They both say the same thing. Return to Drakogen with the Magmatic Annulet. Cool. Ah, guys, that will be next episode. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next one. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.